We are all inspired by different things in different ways. The important thing is that we find what it is that inspires us, and then we must not give up.
You'll get it, Olivia. Stop beating yourself down. It's madness. Just open your eyes.
And see the notes. I know.
Maybe we should stop here for today. Looks like someone could do with some sugar in their tea.
Thanks, Miss Tess. I don't think I can make my lesson tomorrow. I have a dentist appointment.
All right. We'll pick this up again on Thursday then.
Thanks.
She just keeps on repeating the same thing over and over again. Just open your eyes and see the notes. As if I'm playing with my eyes closed.
She's just trying to help you, Liv. She can see that you have a different attitude towards music since, you know.
Well, she could help without the speeches and metaphors.
You really shouldn't let this get the better of you, and more importantly, your music. I can see it, and Miss Tess can see it. You're giving up. If only you knew how good you actually are.
Obviously not good enough.
Honey, I'll never be good enough, no matter how hard I try.
You are good enough. It just wasn't the right time.
Yes, and it'll never be the right time.
Don't do this to yourself, Livy. I'm so proud of you, of what you've achieved, and you should be too. You've received such a wonderful gift. Please don't throw it away because of one silly situation.
It wasn't... It's not a silly situation. It's my life. It's all I know. If I was good enough, I wouldn't be in this situation.
Livy, you are good enough. I know that.
Olivia, I have a challenge for you. It's not a choice, and I do not want to hear any complaints. You are to compose a piece of music from scratch, on your own, and in your own time. It does not have to be longer than 3 minutes, and you are to practice it and perform it next week, Friday.
Miss Tess, I've never written anything before. I can hardly play music composed by other people lately, let alone my own.
Well, then now is the perfect time to start.
But Miss Tess...
No complaints. Goodbye, Olivia.
I've tried, Miss Tess, but I can't do it. I get the first bar out and go blank after that. Please just let me practice the other piece.
Sit down, Olivia. Did you know that Ludwig von Beethoven was almost completely deaf when he composed some of his best works, including the Ninth Symphony? Alan Paterson was diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis, and yet he composed some of the most powerful works of the 20th century. Frederick Chopin suffered from tuberculosis while he was composing, and Olivia, I could go on. You, my dear, have two wonderful working eyes, two well-trained ears, a talent that most people long for, a brain that knows more about music than anything on earth. You are a musician and composer through and through. All you need is inspiration, not to mention confidence.
I'll give it another try.
Ah!
it's half bad either.
I knew that you would open your eyes soon enough. What was it you say you saw?
I saw people falling during sports matches, getting hit and making mistakes. But they got back up. They practiced their skill again and again until they got it right. And I thought, why should music be any different to sports?
I am most proud of you, Olivia Davis.
Thank you, Miss Tess. May I play it for you now?
Actually, I have one last challenge for you. I want you to perform this piece in front of the school this morning.
No way. I'll freeze or mess up and they're all going to laugh and talk about me.
Have you practiced your piece?
Of course.
Did you make mistakes?
Yes.
Well, if there's one thing I know about those two hands of yours, is that they will not make the same mistakes twice. That is, if your heart is in it, as much as your hands are. This piece is special to you, because it's yours. And it's impossible to mess up a piece, or anything which you created for that matter.
But Miss Tess, the audition.
Olivia, you cannot hold the past over your head like this. It will prevent any progress and you will never get any further than this music room if you do. Olivia, music breathes inside of you. And God only knows what was going through Juilliard's head when they did not accept you. But you cannot give up.
What about the people in that hall?
What about them? Anyone who does not appreciate you and your talent is just jealous. And they are not worth you giving up and hiding your gift. Show Juilliard what they missed. It's now or never.
Only when we let go of the past and put aside our fear, only then will we be truly successful in our pursuits.